What's going on, everybody, and welcome to part one of Five Nights at Freddy's 2. This is gonna be a five night series that I do one after the other, so make sure to check out the other videos on the playlist. This is gonna be my first time playing through the game, so cut me a little slack if I slip up here and there. If you want to see more clips and content alike or similar, make sure to follow me on Twitch at DRKKRYPTIK, DRK Cryptic, or follow me on Twitter at CrypticDRK. So sit back and relax, and I hope you guys can enjoy this. Everybody dropped off. I'll get some people back eventually.
Hello, and welcome to your new summer job at the new and improved Freddy Fazbear's Pizza. I'm here to talk you through some of the things you can expect to see during your first week here and to help you get started down this new and exciting career path. Now, I want you to forget anything you may have heard about the old locations, you know. Some people still have a somewhat negative impression of the company. That old restaurant was kind of left to rot for quite a while, but I want to reassure you, Fazbear Entertainment is committed to family fun and above all, safety. They've spent a small fortune on these new animatronics. Facial recognition, advanced mobility, they even let them walk around during the day. Isn't that neat? But most importantly, they're all tied into some kind of criminal database so they can detect a predator a mile away. Heck, we should be paying them to guard you. Now that being said, no new system is without its kinks. You're only the second guard to work at that location. The first guy finished his week, but complained about conditions. We switched him over to the day shift. So, hey, lucky you, right? Mainly he expressed concern that certain characters seemed to move around at night, and even attempted to get into his office. Now, from what we know, that should be impossible. That restaurant should be the safest place on Earth. So, while our engineers don't really have an explanation for this, the working theory is that the robots were never given a proper night mode, so when it gets quiet, they think they're in the wrong room. So then they go try to find where the people are, and in this case, that's your office. So our temporary solution is this. There's a music box over by the prize counter, and it's rigged to be wound up remotely. So just every once in a while, switch over to the prize counter video feed and wind it up for a few seconds. It doesn't seem to affect all of the animatronics, but it does affect one of them. And as for the rest of them, we have an even easier solution. You see, there may be a minor glitch in the system, something about robots seeing you as an endoskeleton without a costume on and wanting to stuff you into a suit. So hey, we've given you an empty Freddy Fazbear head. Problem solved. You can put it on any time and leave it on for as long as you want. Eventually, anything that wandered in will wander back out. Something else worth mentioning is kind of the quirky modern design of the building. You may have noticed there are no doors for you to close. But hey, you have a light, and even though your flashlight can run out of power, the building cannot. So don't worry about the place going dark. Well, I think that's it. You should be golden.
I forgot what you said.
Check the light, put on the Freddy head if you need to. Keep the music box wound up. Piece of cake. Have a good night, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.
This is the regular ones, right? Not the beat up ones that the mask works on. I remember like I had to use this when like certain ones were in the hallway. Flash the light and use that. But I don't remember which ones. Yeah. talking about the balloon kid looking guy? And when they appear in the vents, I flash the light or I put the mask on. The mask on, I'm pretty sure. And they're not harmful right there, right? They get closer. Pretty sure. Almost failed the first one.